charge this bike up to full accidentally. Usually I won't charge it to full, I'll charge it to like 80 or 90%. But yesterday was a really busy day, and I got up at 4 a.m. and I felt like my stomach was really congested. And I did everything I could to try and get things like moving through, because it's like I'm putting food in but it's not coming out again, it feels like. Haven't really had chance to, I have recorded a couple of videos but I haven't really had a chance to edit them because I've just been ill since Christmas basically. Hold my breath when I go in there, because the chemicals in the air make me feel ill. That's just one little example. I found something that really helps. In the past week I've found something that really helps, but it's not a panacea. But it's allowed me to do a lot of things I couldn't. So the main problem I've had since December is I have this disease now called multiple chemical sensitivity, which I didn't have before. So it's kind of a syndrome. I had chemical intolerance before. I'd feel ill in certain rooms, and certain chemicals like bleach and some types of rubber would make me feel slightly ill, like feverish, a little bit confused. My heart would change, sort of, my heart would feel different, heart rate might go up, things like that, but it wasn't really a big problem. But now I've started to basically react to everything. Most furniture, carpets, scents like perfumes, like even things like fairy liquid, Dove soap, things that I wouldn't really react to before, I now react to. And one of the worst ones is, which is how this started, is washing detergent. So if my brother comes to my house, I can smell his clothes from like a long way away, like 10 meters away, I can smell his clothing. I'm super sensitive to the stuff that people wash their clothes with, so I've had to keep like changing my lifestyle. I can smell a lot of things that I couldn't, and they kind of give me reactions, like dishwasher tablets. We used Vanish dishwasher tablets, and I started to be able to smell them. They smell like a sort of rose, like fake rose scent or something, and I started to get like reaction, like a sort of like an allergic reaction when I would use like the frying pan, or like things that had been in the dishwasher that hadn't been washed properly. So I had to change that, and I had to change the, I had to move the tumble dryer outside into the garage. Had to get scent-free laundry detergent and things like this, and I keep having to change lots of aspects of how I live. So I was sleeping on the sofa and had my PC connected to the big TV. Now I'm sleeping on, Jesus Christ, see how fast they pull out, right? See how fast that guy pulled out. Now I'm sleeping on the floor, basically, on the hard laminate flooring. And using my laptop. And I've had to push the sofas as far away as possible. And also remove a lot of stuff, other objects. Sorry, I didn't expect there to be anyone on this path at this time of the morning. Needed to get away from those traffic fumes. Back in like October or something, when I went to that spot, when I went to that crossing, the traffic fumes were giving me something like a burning feeling in the throat. A bit like asthma, but not really. I don't think the pickup's gonna be like as good as it could be. Because the temperatures are near freezing today, this morning. The power of the battery is not gonna be as good as it could be. Bad this car park is. I wouldn't usually ride around here. I have to be really careful not to strain my leg muscles. Because my leg muscles are still recovering from yesterday. Yesterday morning I rode this bike like crazy, like around town, off road and stuff. Which is something I've not been able to do for like ages. Like a couple of months maybe. For independent minds, yeah, that's actually quite rare nowadays. Bloody truck. There's way too much traffic. Yesterday when I went out, there were I went out at like 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. in the morning. There was like almost no cars, and there was like only saw 3 people. It was amazing. I'm not sure who she was talking to. She's like she was talking to herself. Quite like riding around this estate. Oh, it's just cut out. Quite like riding around this estate here. It's quite good roads and it's quite quiet. Yeah, the reason I haven't been able to ride off-road is my muscles have been so sensitive. And what seems to happen is when they just get strained just a little bit, even just like from the force of like standing on the, pushing my feet against the pedals to keep myself on the bike, it's like, it like tires out my muscles like too much, or it pulls them, or it causes a little bit of damage, especially if I'm riding over like bumps like on grass, and that damage seems to trigger my immune system or something, and it sort of like inflames my brain. My brain feels like rough or something. And just, and that is basically the next day or the day after, I've noticed that that's when I'll start to like be able to sense and react to new chemicals that I was fine with before, like for example air purifiers and stuff. Jeez. See, I only weigh 88 kilograms now. It makes a big difference. In the past couple of years, it was like a pipe dream for me to, if I could be 90 kilograms. Because I weighed like around 100. And I just thought, there's no way I'm gonna lose that weight, but I wish I could. But now I weigh like 88 kilograms because I've had to stop eating a lot of the foods that I usually do, like sugary things, chocolate, bread, wheat, pizza, cheese, a lot of stuff. I'm not even putting it into three, I'm just in two the whole time. This road is starting to get pretty fucked up, like, in places. Okay, that'll do. Yeah, I'm literally just trying to drain off like the top 10%, 20% of the battery. I was going to do like a proper ride later on, but I'm waiting for it to get warmer and for the sun to come out fully. It's quite nice yesterday afternoon. It's quite nice. What I've noticed is with this bike, even just riding on it normally, it puts more strain on your arms and legs. I think it's because the handlebars are further forwards or lower down. It's more like an attack position, so you can easily like get up on your feet above the handlebars. For control, whereas with my mid-drive it's more of a sort of casual riding position where you're sort of like more upright and your weight is more on the seat, so the seat is taking more of the bumps and the weight, my weight, rather than my feet, my leg muscles and my arm muscles. So for that reason I've been like riding the mid-drive a lot more than usual, and I haven't rode the stealth bomber for quite a while now because it's just so heavy and I'm just too ill at the moment, or I have been. Yeah, I found something that helps me, but I have no idea why, and that's what I need to figure out. But yeah, it's made the difference of like being able to ride this bike. Was able to go to the supermarket for the first time in, I don't know, 2 months, 3 months. Usually. Lately I'll just go down to Sainsbury's because it's like a much smaller shop and I don't have to like walk as far. But I was able to go to Tesco's yesterday and I was able to walk like all the way to the back of the shop. But I know I need to take it easy today because already this morning I'm like more sensitive to VOCs in my house. Coming off of the sofas and stuff in the room that I'm sleeping, which happens sometimes, but it's not necessarily like a disaster. It just goes up and down. Recently I've been pretty okay, like haven't even been able to smell those VOCs. I've always been like sensitive to like, I've actually always had one aspect of this, which is that like whenever I ride in like cars, whenever I used to ride in cars, and it still happens now but it's worse, but I always feel sick because of like the interior of the car, and especially if the air conditioning's turned on. Yeah, that's always made me feel ill, and I don't think it's just the movement of the car. I think it's like the smell of the inside of the car, like the chemicals that it's made of. But that's always happened for me, and it makes me feel a bit like seasick after a few hours. Even before I became like ill, even when I was pretty healthy, I still experience that.